In this video, you will see the main steps needed to solve these exercises. Try to solve the exercises yourself first, and then you can see on this video that you have all the essential steps. So, what's the question? You have a subspace H, given by the span of some vectors. Vectors U, V, and W are not specified, it's only given that they are in Rn. And then the question is, show that U is in H, V is in H, W is in H, and the final question show that U plus V plus W is in H. So, how can we try to solve this problem? Well, what we could do is to take U equals E1, V equals E2, and W equals E3 in R3. Then we can compute H, it's the span of 1, 0, 0, and then U plus T 2 times V becomes 1, 2, 0. So, and U minus V plus 3 times W becomes 1 minus 1, 3. So H will be the span over here. And then we have to see, for example, whether if we do exercise D, whether U plus V plus W, so 1, 1, 1, is in the subspace. So we have to solve the following vector equation and see whether we can solve that. Whether this equation is consistent or not, and if it's consistent, then U plus V plus W is in H. So this would be a method to solve exercise D. However, what step is wrong in this method? Well, the incorrect step is, for example, that we took here U, V, and W. We made a choice for that, but you have to do this in general. So how do you do this in general? Well, first of all, you start with the definition. U is in H if you use a linear combination of those vectors over here. So you have to find the weights such that U equals C1 times U plus C2 times U plus 2V plus C3 times U minus V plus 3W. Well, can you find such weights? You can try this yourself. This one is not so difficult. Answer is yes. So then you know U is in subspace H. For B and C, you can apply the same method. You can find weights C1, C2, and C3, such that V is the linear combination of those three vectors, and for W as well. And then you arrive at exercise D. Well, nice way to do this. If you know that U is in H, and V is in H, and W is in H, and you know that H is a subspace, then you know it's closed in addition, so U plus V is in H as well, and you do it again, and then you know U plus V plus W is in H. So that's one way you can conclude that U plus V plus W is in H. Another method for exercise D, if you haven't done A, B, and C first, works as follows. Well, you want to show that U plus V plus W is an H. So you have to show that U plus V plus W is a linear combination of these three vectors over here. So you have to find weights C1, C2, and C3. Then you rewrite a bit, combine all terms with a U. So a C1 times U plus a C2 times U plus C3 times U. So that's this term. And for the others as well. And then you can try to solve this linear system over here. And if it's consistent, then you know indeed that your U plus V is in H.